Well, merry fucking Christmas to me. An arch nemesis finally reveals their true identity without a doubt. And of course, you can't say names here, you can't say anything like that, so I'm not gonna. But this is hilarious, and I want you to listen up, and I got reason to listen up. You know what? Oh. What the fuck is that? Oh, it is. We have a saying for you fucking junkies back when I was on the streets. It's called, rock, probably want to crack rock? Probably want to crack rock? Yeah, I know you bitches want it. So listen up. The difference between me and the three of you is that the shit you talk is either completely made up or it's nothing to be made fun of in the first place. The shit you have on me is nothing. And the shit I have on you is the real honest truth. Like, you talk shit about me being trans. You know, whatever. You're homophobic, transphobic, inbred redneck hillbilly bitches. So yeah, I'm transgendered. So what? Who the fuck's gonna laugh about it except some other homophobic, inbred redneck who goes around making fun of everyone that's different? You know? And my name change is legal. You know, there is something in the real world called a legal name change where you can pay like $150, go down to the courthouse, pay the fee, fill out a form, you get a court date, you go before a judge to swear that you're not a criminal or anything, and tell them why you want your name changed. The judge decides if you can have your name changed or not, which he did grant. Then once it's granted, you pay like another $20 to go file your new name. Then you go to the Social Security office, fill out a form to get a new Social Security card, then you get your new card in the mail and you take it to the DMV, and then you go get your new driver's license, and then your name is changed. Approximately a few months later, they change it on your birth certificate too. So guess what? The name you keep calling me does not exist. That is gone. There is no such person. There is only Seth. That is me. Me. That is who I am, and I know who I am, because I don't spend my life in a narcotic-induced daze, alright? And then you talk shit on me for being an animal lover. I mean, so what? Since when is it disgraceful to be a caring person? Being an animal lover just shows that I have a heart and that I'm able to care about someone or something else besides myself, unlike you. You know, so you fail there too. And you used to talk shit about the adoption thing. So what? It's called being responsible and not raising kids on welfare in a fucking crack house. Or leaving them with their grandmother to be looked after while you go to concerts and party and smoke crack and weed and snort pain pills up your nose. So I'm caring, thoughtful, and responsible. Ooh, I guess you got me good. God damn, responsibility. Yeah. So, you know what? And it's not just me either. You'd say all the shit you want about me, but it's not just me. It's everyone else too. You know, I ran into some other ex-friends of yours at the Twisted show in Pittsburgh, and they told me they don't hang out with you anymore because the last time they did, you were harassing and making fun of homeless people, as well as bragging about how you rip off juggalos that do hang out with you. So you know what? No one else wants to hang around you anymore. It's all falling apart in your little world there. And, you know, I've seen, you know, several others around town, and, I mean, they haven't seemed like they dislike me at all. I was actually shocked that the other people I've seen have been like, hey, what's up, and talk to me. But you, I mean, you guys can mean mug me and give me the evil death stare up a Dairy Mart and not say a word to me. But then you go home and you talk shit online like a punk bitch. Because that's what you are. So, you know what? I mean, I don't fucking care. I find it funny as fuck. I find this shit hilarious. how pathetic these little bitches are. And for those who don't know who I'm talking about, because my friends who know me know who I'm talking about, but for those who don't, these are the people who got me into psychopathic in the first place. They brought me into this fam as a joke because they thought, oh, you're too fat and ugly to be a juggalo, so wouldn't that be just a gas? Get this fat fuck into psychopathic. Well, you know, whatever. They're fucking losers. They're fucking junkies. No, fuck them. By the way, I don't do pharmaceuticals. These are my grandma's. You know, I go pick up her meds for her and shit. I don't fucking touch them. I only fucking brought it in here just to fucking tease you because I know you're dying. You're dying to get your hands on this and snort it up. Yeah, fuck you people. I know who I am. I know I'm real. I know I'm down. So, peace out. Whoop whoop to the true fam.